Hi, my name is Christoph Reinhart, and I'm a faculty in the Building Technology program at MIT. Here you see a photo of our program during pre-COVID times. I hope to be able to meet you all during a similar event this September. The Building Technology program is part of the Department of Architecture and consists of 6 faculty and around 30 students working in the areas of structures, daylighting, thermal comfort, operational and embodied energy use, as well as building controls. Being part of the Department of Architecture gives us the opportunity to teach design students the fundamentals of building science in a way that empowers them to actively increase the performance of the built environment in their projects. During the first semester, I teach a class to all entering MArch and BArch students that focuses on daylight and energy use in buildings. The topic is of clear relevance today. As you see on the graph, if we want to keep global temperature rise below 1.5 degrees Celsius in the long run, humanity has around 580 gigatons of CO2 left to burn until 2050, at which point we will need to be carbon neutral. Out of this amount, about 40% can be attributed to the building sector. Of course, we will keep on building new buildings in the meantime. In fact, we are going to double the built area worldwide within the next 30 years. What this means is that we will need to have carbon neutral building concepts for all new types of buildings in 10 years, and we will need to dramatically increase the retrofitting rate from currently 1% to 5% worldwide to reach carbon neutrality for buildings by 2050. As mentioned before, in the Building Technology 1 class, we empower you to design net zero ready buildings. We are using for that a Rhino-based environmental performance tool called Climate Studio that originally came out of our lab. The tool allows you to work, for example, on local climate patterns from solar radiation to wind and temperature. We then start to model the daylight availability throughout the whole building in order to decide which of our concept works best. We are also looking at visual comfort as well as glare analysis to make sure that buildings are thermally and visually comfortable for the whole year in the building. And finally, we are looking at electric lighting design, combining beautiful lighting concepts with low energy use. Finally, we're switching to energy use in buildings, starting with a code-compliant baseline building and then slowly working our way up, reducing energy use by better insulation techniques, better window and shading designs, as well as better HVAC systems. The remaining energy we then top off with renewable energy from photovoltaics. On the research side, our sustainable design lab focuses on developing new simulation technologies for whole cities and neighborhoods. As you see on the slide, we've been working with cities all over the world to help them to develop carbon neutral energy policy concepts. Another topic of key interest in our lab are hydroponic shipping containers, such as the one that you see here on the screen. We are mainly focusing on better understanding what the overall carbon emission of these type of systems is vis-a-vis current agricultural practices, how much energy they use locally, as well as what impact they have on the cost of food, as well as local jobs. Finally, we are focusing on new ways to evaluate outdoor thermal comfort, giving architects the skill sets and the tools to design beautiful outdoor spaces that are used by pedestrians and bikers all year round. I hope this little overview was useful. I thank you for your attention and look forward to seeing you in September. All the best. Stay safe.